And former Latics Tom Cleverley, he's going to be looking to bounce back from his rather disappointing show for England against Ukraine.
Well, I think it's very harsh, disappointing. I think they made too much of the Moldova, and the fact that, you know, I feel for Tom Cleverley because, like, at the moment, I'm still myself, you know, still waiting to see what his game's about, you know what I mean? So as he can actually prove himself in the Man United side and then getting into the England side and doing well. I think what happens is that people do get brought into the England side when they're still developing. There's a lot of hype put around the poor fellas. And then, like you say, off of the Moldova game, everyone was making so much noise about his movement and his play. And then you would come up against a half-decent Ukraine side who obviously watched the game and maybe stifled him a bit and let our centre-halves have it. And when they were trying to come, they didn't come out, for me, well enough with the ball to give it to the midfield players. And they just put pressure on us, Ukraine. And, you know, the touch was wanting. Some of the, you know what I mean, it just didn't happen for him. He missed a couple of chances, unfortunately, for him. And so people are saying, well, it's not quite gone for him. But what we need to do is we need to have a little bit more patience with them and not give them this massive build-up. Just let it happen. Just let it happen slowly. Because I'm sure that he will feel a little bit disappointed by the way it went. And you know, just because he didn't perform maybe as well as he'd like to, the same I suppose could be said about Alex Oxlade-Chamberlain. He's another one who's come to the squad with a lot of hype wrapped around him, and you know, he got substituted as well. So it's one of those where, you know, I think we just need to calm it down a bit. Like, look, little Raheem Sterling. You know what I mean? He's played 205 minutes or something like that in the Premier League, and he's been called into the full squad, whereas, you know, I'm not sure if he's been in the under-21 squad yet. What's the rush? You know, we saw that with Theo a few years back, with Sven taking him to the World Cup. He didn't play, but the expectation that's been on him ever since, I think is something that Theo's had to carry for up to this point in his career, and he's still carrying the expectation. People are still not decided or convinced about Theo, which I think has come from a lot to do with the fact that he's been rushed through. And, you know, I think I just wish we could just calm down a bit about the players that we've got coming through and just let them develop a bit more.
Just needs a bit of time.
Just a little bit more time.